Recording. Here we go. All right, for those of you who are watching this recording, this is the first class for fall 2022 for CIS 134. Recording will probably be about an hour. All right. So that's doing its thing behind the background. This little right here is recording my voice best it can. So if you want to watch it later, you know, all right, when you go on Blackboard, you got your courses, you open this course up and it takes you to the announcements first. I've got that set that way for right now. Actually, it's got some announcements in here from the past I need to remove, but this first announcement right here is actually for this class, but I have this in other places and we'll go over that one at a time. All right, the syllabus, we're going to go over that first because that is a requirement for us to do. Click on that, it opens up a PDF file. It's got lots of information in here. All right, so I am Greg Knight. I haven't introduced myself yet. I've been working here at Wallace State for about 3 years. I consider myself an engineer. I have an engineering degree and all that kind of stuff. I worked in IT and in project management and other industries total about 30 years before I came here. I came here because I wanted to be a teacher, right? And this is the thing that I know, and this is what my degree said I know, so I'm teaching you guys this stuff, right? If I had a degree in, you know, history, I would be over in the history department. But since I have a degree in information engineering, I teach this. You see what I mean? But I also have a lot of experience in this, so really the education that I have is really not as important as all the time I've spent doing this, right? But anyway, that's me. You can get in touch with me at my office with this number here or my email. Send me an email anytime. If you want advising or you need to stop by my office, I have office hours posted on the door and they're also posted in the Blackboard. I'll show you where that is in a bit. So this class, the description's right here, but it's basically what is IT as compared to what is computer science, as what is information systems. There's several different disciplines. We're going to explore all those and prepare them and talk about them. And then we're going to go into all the different aspects of those things. We're going to dig into networks. We're going to dig into computer components. We're going to study databases, programming, cybersecurity. We're going to do a little bit of all of that stuff, right? Some people find when they go through this class, they actually learn which part of an information technology career they actually like the best. This kind of class kind of sets people on the right path, right? Because everyone in computer science has to take this class. So some of you are cybersecurity students, some of you are programming students, some of you are another program, right? We have like 6-8 different degree paths in computer science. So you could be any of those. And I'll learn what those are when I ask you to introduce later. It kind of goes through here and the objectives and talks about what you will know after this. And the way this is broken out, I use two different learning platforms in this class. One is the Google IT Support Certificate platform through Coursera. You may have already received an invitation to that. I sent that out yesterday. Yes.
So I've already done the technical support fundamentals and the basic rights.
You have?
Okay. So do I need to join and do it again? Or
do you have the certificate from it, you can send that to me and you can skip that part.
Okay.
I'll just give you the points for it if you've already done it.
The date's going to be like a couple months ago.
That's fine. Just send me the certificate. Anybody else in that situation? Because you can take the Google IT Support Certificate without being here, but I offered as part of this class because Google actually gives us access to that for free for you guys. So, but I'm going to talk more about that later, but right now just know that that's one of the platforms you got. Did you do it on Coursera?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If you do it outside of here, you have to pay a monthly subscription.
Yeah.
Right, to do it. Since you guys are in class, Google is paying it for you. They do that for community colleges, at least for the time being, right? So don't let that confuse you that he's already done it. That's great. You guys could have done the same thing too if y'all were just paying attention like he is. I'm just messing with you. All right, so we're going to get into that. And we're also going to use Test Out. Test Out is a platform in which you actually have to go buy a code for from the bookstore, right? I got that information here too. If you go to the bookstore website and look up this class, it'll say what to buy. You just go to the bookstore, walk in there and say, this is the class you're in, they'll hook you up with it, right? So either way. I've already sent you guys an invitation to that platform as well. So raise your hand if you think you've got invitations to both of these. Anybody? Not yet? All right, we'll work that out. I'll check it later. And since we got computers in the room, most of them are working, we're going to make sure we get past all that today, at least the best we can. Because I want you to walk out of here feeling like you're armed and ready to go, right? Most of this work you'll be doing outside of class for these, but sometimes we'll do some of them in class together. And sometimes we'll take the examples for those people that want to, because this class is, some people decide to take this class online. So we'll explain that as we go along. Like there are people who are listed in this class who are not here right now. And it's not that they're, you know, stuck in traffic or dead in a ditch somewhere or whatever would be happening. They just decided that they're taking it, but they're going to do it purely online. And they've already sent me a note about it, right? Because this class can be done that way. But what you will miss out on is what I'm going to talk about here in a little bit. But so we're going to use those two platforms, and I'll explain how that works. All right, so the Test Out IT Fundamentals Pro platform is actually preparing you, once you buy the code, you're actually paying for, you'll be paying for the Test Out IT Fundamentals Pro certification exam. That's part of what you're paying for. So toward the end of the semester, you're actually all going to take that exam as part of this class because you've already paid for it. That exam and that whole course is preparing you to take the CompTIA IT Fundamentals Plus exam. You're not going to take that as part of the class, but by the end of the semester, if you do well on that IT Fundamentals Pro exam, you are essentially prepared to take the CompTIA exam. That is something that you would need to venture out on your own and do, because you know the fee for it and all that stuff that the testing center is going to charge you. If you need help with any of that, navigating that, I'll help you, right? So just keep in mind, we have a handful of people do that every semester. More people do. This is a certification that most people walk out of this class with, the IT Pro Fundamentals Pro certificate. So keep that in mind. That's one of the reasons I like Test Out as a platform, is because it's a little bit expensive, but you're paying to take a certification, which is good, right? And it's actually industry recognized and all that stuff. It'd be something that you can proudly display. Matter of fact, I have some examples of the certificate, but I think that since I moved the podium out in the hall, they're out there right now. So I'll show them to you another time. All right, so the outline of topics is here for you to review. Some of the highlights. Install an operating system on a computer. This is actually from Coursera. We're going to what the internet is, how it works, and how it impacts the world, which most of you probably use the internet, probably already used it a dozen times today before you even came to class. Understand network protocols, DNS, DHCP, all this stuff. Grades, there's a lot of points in this class, 3,259 points. We'll go over the schedule and see where those points come from. This is the book that I told you about right here. Up here, the Coursera IT support, you don't have to purchase that, but this other item down here, you do, right? So just keep that in mind. Class attendance policy. All right, this is the school's official policy, but keep in mind that the only way, you're not actually required to attend class. The only way an instructor can really require you is to have points available for like attendance, right? I don't do that. But sometimes people that are here actually get bonus points for stuff, right? Because we do things that you can only do in person. And I can't really require everyone to do them because some people choose to do this online. Are you guys with me? So if you're here and we do things in person with physical equipment or even just working in groups or whatever, I'll often give bonus points for it because I want you to have some skin in the game, have some incentive to be here other than your own well-being. your own well-being is kind of up to you, right? So makeup work policy, let's go over that. Oh, here we go. Let me make sure I see this. So 6 to 8 hours a week is what it takes doing the work to get an A in this class. Any less time than that, unless you're just a genius or gifted or something, some of you might be. If you spend less time than that, you're likely going to make a lesser grade, even to the point where you might not pass. And you guys are like, whoa, I'm not going to pass this class. Well, if you want to pass this class, all you got to do is do the work. That's all you got to do. That's the only way you can learn this type of stuff is just to do it repeatedly, over and over. And that's kind of the way I got it set up. All right. All right. So the late policy, makeup policy. All right. So if you miss a deadline, you'll submit it within a week of the original due date, and you'll get a 20% penalty if you turn it in late. Right. So I let you turn in late, but I'm going to deduct 20%. So know that if you don't get it done on time, you're going to get a penalty. What? Why is that so harsh? Why do I have that so harsh? Anybody want to offer up a suggestion? Am I just a mean person? Yeah.
Because if everyone turned in their work late, then the whole course would be behind, and you wouldn't
hey, that's not bad.
Be able to complete everything that you needed to complete.
I like that.
Within the time frame you were given.
Not bad. Anybody? But yeah. Ma'am.
1 week is already pretty generous.
Yeah. So. I used to actually have it at 2 weeks, and I backed it off because what I was doing was causing people to put themselves behind. Man, I got 2 weeks to make it up. And then next thing you know, because they took 2 weeks to make up what they just missed, they got 2 weeks behind on what they, so I was causing a problem. Plus it's, I'm just going to say from a selfish reason, it's irritating for me to have to go back and grade things later. A whole bunch of people that do stuff late, I have to spend more time on that personally. Does that make sense? And you'll understand why when I show you how this is going to work, because I'll get there. But essentially, I'm not requiring you guys to submit anything. You guys are going to these platforms to clean the work by the deadline, and then I go in and pull the information out and review it and grade you on it. I only do that after the deadline. If you do it late, you have to let me know that you completed it late, and then I have to go back and do it again. You see what I'm saying? How many people are always late with their work? You see my hand raised? I always am or was, right? I was a student that was working full time and chasing babies around and all that stuff. I did that for years and years and years. I've been to school way too long, right? So I was always like that. And I used those other things in my life as an excuse as why I was late. And there really is not an excuse. We'll do that exercise in a minute. Be thinking about right now, be thinking about a good excuse for not getting your work on time, and I want you guys to throw them at me in a bit, right? You got one?
I eliminated them all.
There you go. Yep.
I got an excuse.
Well, hold on to it. Yeah, give me a minute to think about it. All right, classroom etiquette, just be respectful. If you need to make a call or take a call, just do it out in the hall or somewhere else. It's fine that you do. I will answer the phone myself in here. I'll tell you guys now. This might be a test question later, but I will answer my phone when it rings. It's only going to ring for two different people, my wife and my son. That's the only time it's going to ring. I have my phone set to silent for everyone else, right? So when those two call me, I'm going to answer it. If you have people in your life that depend on you for things, I expect you to answer their call too, and that's fine. Just when you talk to them, just do it out in the hall. Even though I might do it sitting right here. I'll be like, I'm in class right now. What do you want? Right? And they'll be like, oh, sorry. And they'll hang up. Or there'll be something serious going on. But that's the only time I'm going to answer it. All right. They are also a policy about wearing hats in class. I don't care about that. So you can wear a hat if you want. I don't know why that's a thing. Email. If you email me, I'm going to respond to you during the business week quick. It'll be, but my requirement is to do it within 24 hours. You'll likely get a response quicker than that. If you email me and it's something urgent and I haven't responded to you in a what you feel is a reasonable amount of time, email me again or call me. That's fine. If it's on the weekend, I will still probably respond to you. It'll just be a little slower, right? And I am aware I've made your deadline Sunday, right? So you're sometimes going to be in the middle of your assignments on Sunday, Saturday or Sunday, and you'll be like, crap, I sure wish I could get a response from my instructor right now. I'm aware of that, so therefore I do pay attention to email on the weekends most of the time, unless I'm distracted by something fun, you know, which sometimes happens. Technical support, this is all the stuff you need for Blackboard support. The honor code, do your own work, basically is what this says. I don't want you hiring, you know, Bill Gates to sit down and do your homework for you, right? Or whoever you can afford. All right, so we are pro ADA and we are anti-harassment or discrimination, right? That's what these two things say. If you need accommodation, there is a director of special populations here. You can go to them, fill out the paperwork, and I will accommodate. If you need to take a break at any moment, you can do it. This class is long, you know, it's 2.5 hours every time we meet. So we will always take a break. Is this how long we've been in here now? 45 minutes. This is not quite time for it yet, unless you guys think it is. What do you think? We're on a roll. Let's give it a minute. Let's get to the end of the syllabus first, maybe the end of the schedule. But if you need to, you can take a break anytime you need to. If you have a complaint about the class, I would like you to take it up with me first. If I don't resolve it for you, you can go to the department chair, Mr. Ayers. He is here in the building. If he doesn't resolve it, you can take it to the Dean of Academic Affairs, who will, you know, get to the bottom of it. I've only had that happen once since I've been here for 3 years, where it made it all the way to the dean. And it got resolved. All right, inclement weather. So here we're in the fall semester. What kind of weather do we have to look forward to? Well, eventually there'll be cold outside, right? We'll have icy roads and things. This class is at 9:30 in the morning. It is possible that we will be subject to some late openings of school. So just give you an example. If the school opens at 10 because of icy roads and it's on the day of this class, that means we're not having class. You guys get that? You don't have to show up at 10 because the class started at 9:30. We're just not having class that day. Does that make sense? If we're here and then they close the school, then we'll just leave, right? So no big deal. you will likely not get an independent notice from me about the class specifically. The school will send out a notice. Class is delayed opening until 10, 11 today. But if it opens late before this class starts, then you should come, right? But if you have questions when that arises and you want to email me, then please do. Are there some technology requirements for this class? I would encourage you to read those. Basically, you just, you know, need a computer with a webcam and the capability of running these programs. All right, we still got a COVID statement in here. We were required to keep that in, so feel free to. Basically, we're aware COVID is a thing. It's out there and it's in the world, and by coming and being around other people, you may catch it. It's basically what that says, and you're aware of that. All right, this is how to get help. There's a help desk here at Wallace who does help students with problems. I can't reset your password, but we'll be getting past some of that today. You probably, how many people have not signed into their Blackboard or their email yet? Anybody got that problem? All right, well, we'll get you past that today. So remind me to have you try that before we go. All right, there's a whole list of procedures here. If you need those, I would follow those. If you have a technology issue and missing assignments, all right, so that's one of those excuses that's not an excuse. So we'll talk about that in a minute. Campus police, they are here to help you. If this is your first time on campus here and you haven't already put the campus p- police number in your telephone, I would. It's listed up by the door up there. See that number by the door? If you just want to call the campus police, like you've got a locked out of your car, you got a flat, or you just want somebody to escort you to your car because somebody's acting weird around you or whatever, you can call this number. And that goes directly to the guy in the car, right? He'll be here. It's like that. There's an emergency, dial 911. So I would program this in your phone if you feel like you want that number, and just keep it handy because it's they're very helpful. They're here to protect and serve the campus. Building evacuation. All right, well, let me make sure this appears. Okay, this disclaimer just basically says I may change the syllabus and schedule while this class is underway. And if I do, I'll let you know. It's unlikely I'm going to change the syllabus. If I do make a change to anything in here, it's going to be these points right here. But like when I put this together last couple of days, this was the point values we were working with. But if those were to change in a significant way, I would make an announcement of that. Anybody feel overwhelmed yet? There's a lot of information. Anybody already had their instructor go over this with you in another class this today? Was that a lot of fun?
Sure.
What class was that?
Algebra 2.
Oh, yikes. Okay. Yeah. I did a lot of math at one time as well. I get it. So where do I leave off? All right, the evacuation procedures. If we need to evacuate this building, somebody give me a for instance. Why would we need to evacuate this building? Fire is a good one. Chemical spill, because somebody tells us to, whatever. Right? If we evacuate from this building, right here in this diagram right here, we are this room right here. See where my mouse is right over here? You guys see that? That is the room we're in. The red lines right there aren't necessarily correct, but because we could, you see this little area, this little hall right here? We could go that way. But basically, there's an exit really close, just kind of opposite where we are on the other side of the building, that lets out over here on this grassy area. But no matter where you exit the building, it should be right there, and we'll likely do it together. We are to meet up in that spot where all the arrows are pointing. There's a little picnic table sitting in the grass between these two buildings, these two parking lots. It's the collection point. I've only ever had to do this since I've been working here once, and it was during a drill. So sometimes they actually do drills. It could happen. There's going to be a temptation to go to your car and go home. Don't do that. Because we won't know what happened to you. Just show up and let me just make sure that everybody's accounted for, and then maybe we'll dismiss you from there. All right. All right. Very good. That was the syllabus. Nice. I feel like we've accomplished something here today. All right, let's go to the schedule. This is actually the meat of things right here. I want you to get really intimately familiar with this schedule because this is going to help you stay on track. All right, the very first thing we got going on here is the attendance verification assignment, which is the getting started quiz. I've got on there due immediately because I have to, and if you don't understand what that means, attendance verification, I mean, you showed up, you think that would be enough. Well, sadly, it is not. Attendance verification is an activity that your instructor puts out there that you have to do to verify that you are a real person showing up for a real class, right? It's some kind of a regulation thing. Are you with me? You do this, I will see that you've done it, and I'll go in and I will mark you attendance verified in the system. Therefore, you will not get dropped from the class when they do that next week, right? If you fail to do the attendance verification, I can't mark you as verified, and then they will drop you from the class. When I say they, the Wallace State computer system will drop you because it's almost as if you don't exist. Are you with me? Even though I see you right here. Here you are. If you don't do that one little thing, it's just the way it works. That what that attendance verification assignment is, I'll show you in a minute. Matter of fact, what we're doing right now is actually working toward that, going over all this stuff. All right, the schedule, just like I showed you, we got two different things here. We got the Google Quick Labs, which you'll do in Coursera, And then you got test out IT Fundamentals Pro. So each week, I want you to notice there's two columns of things to do. You got to do some of it in one platform and some of it in the other. Those of you who have been in some of my classes know that I often use more than one platform. I do that to just really load you up with a lot of information. I've tried to balance it so that it's not so overwhelming every week, right? All right, look over here on the points side. So this little slash right here. So somebody kind of tell me what I'm doing right there. Can somebody read that for me? What are the 100 points for in this scenario?
Google.
Yeah, right. Every Google Quick Lab graded assignment is 100 points. That's the way Google has it set up. So I just kept it that way. All right. In test out, you see you've got a collective amount of 45 points for doing both sections 1 and 2. You guys see that? So if you were going to be delinquent on something that week, which one would you pick? Yeah, you would. Yeah. If you have to ration your time, right? I would rather you do it all, but just do it smart, right? If you have to be delinquent on something, lose the 20% on the one that's worth less points. No brainer, right? All right. I've had to make those kind of decisions a lot in my educational career. Which thing do I want to fail this week, right? So it is. How many of you are taking 4 classes right now? All right. How many are taking 5? There you go. Is there any people with 6 or 7 classes? Right. When you got that many classes, sometimes you got to prioritize what you can do this week. You know what I mean? I would love for you to think that IT, I like to believe that IT fundamentals is the priority in your whole life. This is what you do before you go to church. This is what you do before you kiss your mother. This is the priority for you. But I know the reality is not that. For all I know, it's algebra 2. You know what I mean? What is this thing doing to me? Hey, we're getting some news here. All right. So that's how that works. We're going to go into each one of these platforms in a bit. Notice about sometime in November here, we actually finish up test out and we only have the Google IT support work to continue. You see that? That's what's happening. I will assign you a writing assignment. You know, it doesn't show in here when I'm assigning it to you, but I will make that known, and then you will you'll have most of the semester to complete that. I'll do that here in a week or two. Assign that to you. It's just a way to bring you outside of all this stuff and kind of apply some critical thinking to what you've learned, or give you a chance to research something maybe that's of interest to you. But we'll talk about that in a couple of weeks. May run across it in Blackboard here in a minute. Any questions about the schedule? How important is this schedule to being successful in this class? Anybody? How important do you think this is? It's very important. Matter of fact, if I was you, I would print this out and keep it next to wherever you do your homework, or download it and keep it visible on the screen, something, because it's you're going to want to know these dates. And notice these dates, the 28th, and I know this looks kind of silly, me up here drinking this huge bottle, but this was the only bottle I had, right? You guys, that didn't look silly at all. It looks refreshing. Is anybody thinking that? It really is. I mean, it's wonderful.
Can you work ahead?
Good question. You can. You can do as much ahead as you want. Matter of fact, if you have events in your life, you know where you're not going to be able to work in the future for that week, you know that you would miss your deadline, then you probably should go ahead and work ahead. Yeah. I would encourage it. Matter of fact, I've had students finish all of this early, and once I get into talking about the Google IT certificate a little deeper, you'll understand why. I'm only requiring you to do 2 of the modules for the Google IT cert in this class, and there's actually 5 of the modules. So in order to complete the entire Google IT support certificate, you have to do the other 3. One of those is also, I include in CIS 149. That's an online class. Many of you are probably in that as well. How many is in 149? All right, so one of the modules you will do in there, and the other two, it's just up to you as an individual to be motivated enough to do, right? So we'll talk about that more. Other instructors, they look at my schedule and they say, man, you sure do make this hard for yourself using two different platforms and having these students navigate two different platforms. And they're like, why do you do that? I said, I do that because it's good for them, right? I can put up a little bit of irritation with two platforms if they can learn more, right? So, plus, I really would love to see people earn. I've had, since we've been doing the Google IT support certificate for, I guess it's going on a year and a half, maybe 2 years now. We've had about 20 students complete the whole thing. That number seems kind of low to me because each semester I have about this many students in this class. So that's 20 out of, you know, a couple of hundred probably. So what is that, about 10%? That seems low. I would like to see more of you do it. But the problem is the five classes, the six classes, you got other things. So taking on something that's not actually required can be a bit of a stretch. But some of you have it in you. I can see it. So, all right, let's go back to the, all right. So we went through the syllabus schedule, that attendance verification activity. All right, here's the thing. This is what's required for attendance verification. You have to complete the Getting Started quiz, right? The Getting Started quiz is down here. I'm going to show you this quiz. You guys have to do this on your own, but I'm going to show you the quiz. All right, there's two questions on this quiz, right? The first one, I have reviewed, understand, and agree to comply with the policy, procedures, and instructions set forth in the syllabus, schedule, and by this instructor as outlined. All right, there's really only one correct answer to this. I'll let you figure out what that is. Next one, question two, is a webcam required for this course? If you look here, let's see, where was it? Webcam required. You will need a webcam to use Respondus Lockdown Monitor for this class. So I'll ask you, is a webcam required for this class? There's only one correct answer. You guys know what it is? All right, so I would answer both of these questions correctly. Otherwise, I'm going to have to track you down and say, okay, do this again, please, right? You guys, and once you do this right here, you are then attendance verified. You are a real person, heart and a soul and an A number, and you're out here in the world. Okay, so do that when you get a chance. Actually, if you want to, you can do it today before you leave, but we'll move on right now. Let's, all right, where do we leave off here? And instructor information. This is the stuff that I've already told you about me. Office hours are listed here. The areas in green on here, actually, this is out of date. I'm sorry. Let's see, am I in the right class here? Yeah, I need to update this. This is for the spring. So I will. I'll update it. When you see it, the areas that are, it'll be just like this. The areas that are in green, I'm in a classroom. The areas that are in orange, I am somewhere else, mostly in my office, right? At least that's where I'm supposed to be. If you come to the building and you see that it says office and I'm not around, I will be around pretty quick. I'm just a few steps away.
You were here in the main.
Yeah.
Instead of
Aniana. On
Thursday.
Yeah. Five. Well, it has it going to, yeah, I didn't actually have the time right here, but yeah, this is it. Right, this is your class right here. See how it, you're right. Yeah, because I saved myself travel to Aniana and I never show myself coming back.
Yeah.
Which I did. I did come back. I went to Aniana, taught a class, and came back for the 5 o'clock class. Yeah. Yeah, I had a student or two point that out to me last semester, too, and I never changed it, or back in the spring. But I'll, I need to update this. I thought I had done that already, so I'll get that done for you. But you can always call or email me as well, and I will respond. There is a way to message me within Blackboard. A lot of instructors are going to want you to do that. I don't really like that because it comes in as an email, but it doesn't say anything. I have to go to Blackboard to then message. So what it does is delays you getting a response, because if I'm doing it from my phone, I don't know what you're asking. Are you with me? But if you want to do it that way, that's fine. And I try to not make that highly visible in here. Matter of fact, I should probably put an email location in here. And I can do that. I can put an email spot under support down here. But if you do send me a message about the class, keep in mind there's a lot of you. And I'm going to learn your names as we move on. At least I'll try Dylan, Logan, or Summer Crimson. Right? I may make up a name for you like I did for those guys. Because the actual name is Dylan and the actual name is Crimson. But for some reason, I've made up my own names for these guys. I want him to be Logan. Right? Anyway, I do pretty good with trying to remember your names. But when you send me an email and say, for this class, how many classes do I have with this one student? Which class are they talking about? And I can usually figure it out if I take a minute to think about it. But if you just tell me what class it is, hey, we're ahead of the game, right? I can spend less time worrying about what class it is and then coming up with a solution for you. Are you with me? So just tell me what class it is. CS, you know, what is this class? 134? CS 134. You can even call it by the name, IT Fundamentals, whatever works for you. If you want to take it to the point of giving me the CRN number, that's good too, but something that identifies this particular class. And we're off to the races. All right. So I'll fix this schedule. Anything else in here that's important? Yes. Go Blazers. Any Blazer fans in here? Come on. Let's hear it. Never is. All right. UAB Blazers, you know, that team down in Birmingham. You guys know what I'm talking about. How many Bama fans then? Anybody? More of those, okay. Auburn. Wow. LSU, Mississippi State, Texas A&M, Atlanta Falcons. All right. So not sport, not a big sports group. Okay. Atlanta Braves.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, really? Cool.
She's crimson with a C, right? Yeah. All right. Two crimsons in the class. So I'll have to come up with your alternate name, too. So we'll see what that's going to be. Because she's Summer every time I see her. She's not crimson.
Well, yeah. I go by a different name.
Okay. Well, we'll get. As a matter of fact, I haven't even done the role yet. Yep.
Actually, me and him played the state championship in football.
Oh, okay.
Movie stadium this year.
Oh, that was at Progressive?
Yeah.
Yeah. That didn't make you into at least a sideways fan?
It almost did. It was pretty amazing.
Yeah. Yeah. My I worked at UAB for 20 years, and I'm a UAB alum, and all that just makes me a fan. Being an alum for one, working there didn't really do it quite as much. And my son is actually a UAB police officer down there now, so I have a lot of reasons to be a UAB fan. So, he is in week 19 of the academy right now. Yeah, Crimson's been kind of aware of this.
Wasn't he, like, taking classes here, though?
Yeah, he was. Okay. He's had to pause that. He'll be back eventually. Okay. You can't do the police academy and be in college at the same time.
How many weeks is it?
It's like 14, 16 weeks. It's crazy long.
I can't remember. I knew it was around that.
It's crazy long, yeah. But, you know, he's going to be walking around with a gun with the authority to tackle people to the ground. You know what I mean? So they got to – anybody police in here already? Or have been? No? It's a rough gig, but that's what he wants. So I was always looking for a job with air conditioning and a desk myself. And I almost found there's almost air conditioning in here today. Almost. I mean, at least it's not quite as bad out as outside. All right, where do we leave off? All right, we need to start looking at some of these platforms, right? So, all right, let's look at this announcement up here again. So this was your announcement to test out LabSim, right? So you click on this link and it's going to take you so you can sign up for this particular classes. Show of hands for anybody that's already done that. All right, I'm going to take a look at it really quick. Let me see if my recording is still going on. It says it is. Let's see. All right, that's I'm going to test out here. I'll take a look. All right, so the entire community college system classes are out here. You all should really only see one or two of these, depending on how many classes of mine you're in. Because you got some of you guys are also in 199, CS 199. How many of you guys in that?
I don't know the
number, but the other one is network. Yeah, that's 199. So show those hands again. Yeah, so a lot of you, I may have some of you guys for three classes, right? You'll be like, I'm getting tired of seeing that. Well, the problem is if you're in the cybersecurity and networking, you're going to see me a lot. I mean, you'll see me for 2 years, right? So that's, there is another cybersecurity teacher. You'll see him as well, Mr. Pierce. So, all right. So this class is this one right here. So let's see. Got a lot of you guys in here. All right. So how many did it say? So there's 12. So yeah, still got some room to go. There's about 30 people in this class. So a lot of people still need to. So if you haven't clicked that link and done that, you need to do that. You'll see listed here as the instructors, me and Rachel Kreps. Rachel is our department secretary. Sometimes she grades stuff for me, especially if it doesn't require any judgment calls, if it's just a matter of marking it down. So that's why she has access to the class. So if you wondered who that is, that's who it is. All right. So let's get into this. Let me show you what it looks like. I'll show you how this is going to work. All right. So when you get in there, get into the test out, it's likely going to start right here. There is a menu over here where or outline where you can click to be anywhere you want to be within the class, right? I go into this over and over again, so I always seem to be in the wrong spot, but this is what it looks like from the beginning. What I want you to notice in this outline right here, over here under the sections, there is, you've got all these different types of activities. Like this one here is, see the little, this is a video. It's got the little, play button icon. This is a little course overview. It's just got some information about things. There'll be lots of informational type sections in here that you're going to probably find valuable to read, right? It's going to help you once you get down to this quiz. So they have section quizzes, and they also have practice questions that are listed like this. The little pencil pointing to a piece of paper. You guys see that? That's important because that's what you're getting graded on here. You're getting graded on this little pencil piece of paper thing. These other items right here you're going to want to do for your own education and to prepare you to take that quiz, but I'm only going to grade you on the quiz itself, right? That's going to be points in when you complete the quiz. Test out's going to record those points. All right, so let me go to another example. Section 2 right here has got, actually it's also got quizzes. So you guys see the difference? All of these things are important, but the quiz is what you need to do to make sure you get points, right? Some of you may already be, have enough, just because you guys are technology generation, whether you realize it or not, computers and the internet and all that has been part of your life, for many of you, your whole life, right? I mean, like always. So you already know some of this stuff, whether you realize it or not. There's no penalty to just go ahead and try the quiz. You can do these quizzes and test out as many times as you want to get the score you want. Are you with me? So if you feel like you can just jump in and take a quiz without going through the material, that's a decision you need to make for yourself. As you go further through test out, that's going to be harder to do. But early on, you might be able to do it. Save yourself some time, right? Let me go to section 3. Section 3 also, the other thing that's going to be graded are the items with the mouse here. These are labs. So anything that's the section quiz or, does it always say, the pencil with the paper or the little mouse. Those items are going to be graded. All right, so you start up the lab. The way the lab works, it's got a virtual workspace for you, and you've got instructions over here, right? So you want to make sure you do every step of the instructions, by clicking on the various things, and, take your time, do it right. I've got a couple of videos on some of these. So if you struggle with some of these, figuring them out, we'll do some of them in class to kind of get you on the right track. But this one is in the very beginning. I really want you to go and struggle with it, because that's how you learn this, is to do the struggle. And then when you feel like you've done everything that's in this list over here, you just click score lab, It's going to come up and give you a score. I didn't do any of them, so it's like, whoa, I missed them all, right? But once you do score, it actually tells you what you should have been doing, right? And what do you do then? If you miss something and you want to make sure you get it, just go back and do it again, right? Do it until you get it right. Do it until you've learned how to do it. Don't, this is what you're supposed to be doing here. You're supposed to be learning this stuff. Yep.
So do you get all the points if you do it like two times?
You can do it as many times as you want. I will take the highest score, right? What the report looks like to me, and I'll just show you guys that just so you can see it. So you see what I'm talking about. What's going to happen is I'm going to go. I'm going to have some people have actually joined this since I looked at it the last time. Three of you have just joined, so thank you for that. I'm going to go in and view class reports, and I'm going to run the class gradebook, right? And I'm going to have it show as points, and whatever points it's got listed for you for that section, I'm going to add them up, and I'm going to enter them in Blackboard, right? If you've done these things multiple times, then it's going to have it show you have done it multiple times, and I'm going to just put the highest one in, right? No big deal. See, I'm on it. I'm only grading you on exams and labs. It's just too many points with all that other stuff. Plus, sometimes you're not going to want to do all the other stuff. You're going to want to scan it, watch a video a little bit, and move on. And that's okay. Spend the time on the things you need to, not just because it's there, right? All right, what else do we have in this class besides test out? See, under the test out link right here, you have a link to test out, and you also have that same invitation that is in the announcement. So that link is here. This link is only good for 7 days, and that was as of yesterday. So you want to go ahead and get this joining done pretty soon. If you do try to join it later and this is expired, you're going to have to let me know and I'll have to send you another link. So just keep that in mind. For those of you who are listening to the video, same thing. All right. Other thing. All right. So you've got the Google course. All right. So I actually did send you guys a...
I received an invitation.
Yeah. And that was sent out, where did I do that? Yeah, I sent that via email yesterday. So I need to go and check that out. Let me see here. All right, so Coursera looks a little different. Now keep in mind, I have covered Blackboard, I've covered Test Out, now I'm doing Coursera. That's three different things, right? And you've got multiple classes that are going to have multiple different things. So sometimes you're going to sit down and do your work, and you're going to think, okay, what the heck? How do I even do this? Well, get into a rhythm with it. Do it repeatedly, methodically, with some type of discipline, and it won't be that big a deal. How many people are scared right now they're not going to keep up with this? That's not true. She can do it, right? Crimson can do it. Let's think Crimson. Yeah, I think she can. I would sell you guys on the high points of Crimson's resume, but we'll let that unveil itself later. She is a Skills USA rock star, we'll say that. And we'll explain that later, because I'm going to introduce Skills USA to you guys as the semester moves on, try to recruit you for the team, and I'm going to use Crimson as the poster child for that. Right? So... Anyway, we'll talk. If that's interesting to you already, you can ask me about it offline. All right, so welcome back. Let's log into this thing here. This is what Coursera looks like. All right, so I got to click on some traffic lights here. I guess that's good enough.
Am I the only one that, you don't know whether to do the edges of the line?
No, you're not the only one that's that is a confusing thing, but you just have to suffer through it and get through it, right? All right, so let me... find your course here. Let's see here. Where's that? No, I don't really need. I need to look at your status here. No, I need to go into the other quicks. It's the home. All right. So you guys have a course that looks like this that I invited you to. Notice this particular program has 5 courses in it, right? So let me show you. So I've invited 31 people and only 3 have joined, right? So so I invited all of you, right? Based on your, well, matter of fact, I'll just take a look here. Let's just, let's go back. It's not what I need. I need to view you guys. All right, this is, okay, so some people have actually accepted. They just haven't joined yet. And so this is, so I can, invited but never joined. So these are the, if you're on this list, I've invited you, but you haven't joined. And mostly, I believe all, I pulled these emails from your student record. And most of these, I think all of these are your Wallace State student email.
Where does the invitation go?
It should go to your inbox for your student email. So if you're not familiar with that, I need to make you familiar with it.
I am, and it didn't.
It didn't go? Which one is you?
Josh Pace.
Pace? Mm-hmm. All right, yeah, we can take a look here. I can resend it and see what happened. Does it show you here? Did you?
Yeah, it's not.
Tell me to stop.
No, PACE.
Oh. What kind of, okay, Josh. So it's got joshua.pace, student.wallstate, and you. So that's, is that you for real?
Sure. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, we'll need to get past that. So I'll, I think I can go back and resend it now. Let's see. You're about to send a reminder to 28 learners. All right. So we'll send that, see if that reminder shows up.
Did you get an email from me today about your course being updated, Blackboard being updated?
Yeah, that was in 149. Yeah. Yeah, that class isn't really ready yet. It's an online class, and I haven't done a lot of this work for that one yet.
So I did get it.
Good. Well, that came from Blackboard. This one's coming from Coursera, so it's a different kind of deal. All right, well, let's get into the class and just show you what the work looks like, and then I'll give you guys some time. Matter of fact, we're going to go longer than we're going to want today. I'm going to give you guys a break. Yes, sir.
I'm in the introduction to computers.
Yeah.
So is that all on Blackboard?
It's all online. Yeah, it's Blackboard, and it's on 2 other platforms, too. There'll be a video explaining that for you.
Okay, on Blackboard.
And you can always ask anybody in here.
Okay, just videos on Blackboard?
Yeah. But it's not there yet, but it will.
Yeah, because I looked this morning and nothing's there.
Yeah, there's nothing there this morning. No, I'm a procrastinator. I was off last week, and then Monday I was supposed to come to work, and instead of coming to work, I was at the hospital. My wife put me a whole day behind. She's fine now, but spending the day at the hospital, there's nothing you can do but just sit there. I lost 8 hours of time, which I should have dedicated to you. All right, you guys take a break. Be back in 7 minutes. That's a hard 7. Like in 7 minutes, I'm going to move on without you. I would encourage you to take this break. I set a timer here so I don't lose track. The hallway up toward the office area up there, the air conditioner actually works better. So if you need to be cooled off, go stand there for a minute. They actually told us yesterday they're going to upgrade the AC in this building, but you guys will be graduated by then. So
it's a fan or something circulating.
Yeah, I'm not sure why it's not working. In fact, I'm going to go check it out, see if the secretary can call it in real quick.
I'll be right back.
I think the thermostat's good. Yeah, it's almost like we should open a window or something. Do that, maybe get some air from here. Did that alarm go off yet? No? All right, so we still got a minute or so. Probably haven't been open in like 100 years. I don't think it could hurt him, you know? You guys watch out for that window back there, don't trip on it. We got like a minute left. Is everybody missing? You guys, your partner missing next to you? I learned from years of like corporate meetings and conferences and even college and stuff, when somebody gives you a break, you don't walk around. It's tempting to just kind of stay there and tough it out, but so we are going to everybody's here. It feels full. Does anybody think anybody's missing? Oh, there is a couple. Okay. Well, that's time either way. So, hey, look at that. Perfect. All right. I did kind of gloss over at the end here. There is a final exam that we'll take. We'll do that on Blackboard at the end. So it'll be outside of, it won't be within Test Out or Coursera, but it'll be on those subjects you learned there. It's pretty heavy in points, so it's a pretty good percentage of the grade. But by the time we get there, to that point in the schedule, we will have, you will have done all this other work, and we will also do a pretty hefty review, right? So it won't be anything that you need to be stressed about. But since this is an academic college credit awarding institution, I have to give you tests, right? So. Which is okay. All right. So for those of you who are watching this online, I am going longer than an hour. I thought, hey, we didn't miss Crimson. You guys didn't tell me she was not here. Come on. Crimson, you're supposed to be looking out for Crimson. Where did I leave off? What was my goal here, guys? Somebody help me out. Oh, yeah. All right. So when you're inside, let's see, where do we go here? This is the course once you get inside. This is what it's supposed to look like to you. You guys tell me if it does. And once you scroll down, there is this item right here, this little box, Google IT support. This is the program, right? So when you click this box, it opens up and you've got five different courses listed here. All right. For this particular class, you're required for your grade to complete technical support fundamentals. And a bit later on in the schedule, you'll see it'll shift from technical support fundamentals, you see, and it'll shift to the bits and bytes of networking. Looks like that happens around November the 13th, right? From a schedule perspective, that's how it works. The tech support fundamentals is where you're going to start. So you're going to click into that and you're going to go to course. You got an invitation already to this. And I will tell you, I mentioned it earlier. And tell me your name, sir.
Annika.
When he mentioned that he's already completed the tech support fundamentals section because he did it on Coursera. Coursera is a platform that's accessible to the public at large as long as they pay a subscription fee, right? That's like $50 a month or something like that. $49 a month.
$50, yes.
And you can take all kind of classes on there, right? It's their business model. Well, Google has used them for this platform so people can earn this certificate. And they offered this to community colleges through a pilot program a couple of years ago for free. Are you with me? So Google is actually paying Coursera for you to have access to this. They're doing it. They're doing it as a community, endeavor, right? And so you have access to it because you're taking it here at the school. Are you with me? So I want you to take full opportunity of that. So I'm requiring you in this class to do the first two of the five courses, technical support fundamentals and bits and bytes of networking. There are three other classes or modules in that program. Let me go back here and, all right. Well, that's actually inside. Well, I'm going to, see, I've actually already completed this before, so I'm going to get into the, mine looks a little different. See how all these check marks right here? You guys want these check marks. You don't have them yet. But let's compare what this, this work looks like compared to what I'm requiring you to do for a grade. Okay. Two different things going on here. You want to earn the certificate, maybe, and you want to pass this class. There actually can be independent of each other, but for the purposes of this class, I've merged them together, right? So for this Coursera, Google requires you to get 80% on the graded items in here in order to consider passing for the certificate. Mr. Knight doesn't care what you get on. You want to take and get 60 on it and not repeat it, do it again because you're okay with that. I'm going to record 60 for your grade and I'm going to move on, right? But that means you're taking yourself out of the running to get a certificate because if you don't get 80% on everything, Google is not going to award you the certificate. You guys understand that? If you don't do it at all, I'm just going to record a zero and then I'm going to move on. Yeah.
Do you want me to email the certificates I already have, or I can share
it to you? Yeah, just email it to me. Okay. And I'll just, when it comes to weekly assignments on that, I'll just mark you as done.
Okay.
Right? But once we get to about November or so, we switch to the bits and bytes, then you got to kick in. Oh, you've done that one too? Well, email them both then. That's fine. Yeah. Maybe. Have you done all five of them already?
Not all five. I have two.
All right. If I was you, I would just use that time that you're not doing this and do the other one. Right. And very good. All right. Let me get back to what I was saying. All right. So the schedule. All right. So the very first thing here on due by the 28th, which is pretty generous time in the future. Right. I kind of gave you guys a little bit ahead of time, a little bit of a acclimation time. I didn't require anything to be due this weekend. I waited till next weekend. Only thing you got to do this time is the attendance verification, right? Give you a chance to get your, self-organized. And you're welcome. You guys are like, what? That's a huge gift. You don't, you're not even aware how huge a gift that is. The gift of time, right? Anyway. So first thing you're going to do is this technical support fundamentals graded quiz, how to count in binary. So you've got to be able to find that in here, right? You want to do all of these things, but both Google and Wallace State is only, you only have to do the actual graded quiz, and I'll find it. Here it is at the bottom. How to count in binary, right? So this is the one item out of all of that stuff that you've got to do in order to get the points. You got to go through and do this binary calculator. And don't trust me, before you get to this, you're going to know. So anybody want to take a swag at one of these right now? What's this? What they want us to create the number 72 in binary. Any thoughts? So binary is basically, and I explain this in Coursera, I'll start explaining it. Binary is a numbering system that only has two digits, 0 and 1, right? So you're either on or you're off. So each one, in this particular situation, these slots all have a value that's associated with them being turned on or off. So if I want the number 72, I've got to turn on the right values in order to make it add up to 72. So what do you think the first number I want to start with? 128? Do I want to use 128? That's too much, right? So about 64. Yeah, let's turn that one on. 32, that would make it too much, right? So what is 64 plus 16, somebody? Too much, right? How about 64 plus 8? All right, so what is that? Does that add up? 64 plus 8 is... actually, that's just right. Yeah, that's 72, right? So you're going to do that with all of these, and then you're going to check your answers, right? If you get all of those in green, then you've completed it, right? And that's the assignment. That's 100 points in the first one. It seems some people that's going to be difficult. Some people it's going to be very easy. It just depends on where you are in your learning. Matter of fact, we don't have time to do them all right now, but that's your thing. Now the items in Coursera are going to get progressively harder, just like they are in, test out. All right. What have I not done? Where did I leave off? I told you what we were expecting to do today. What have we not done? Introductions. That's right. And that is very important. And I'm going to explain why. Right, so I'm going to turn this off. Does anybody feel like they're walking out of here ready to work in Coursera and test out? And if not, we need to get you there.
I do have a question.
Yeah.
So the test out, can we purchase that online, or do we have to go into the bookstore to?
Are you asked the question so I can answer it? You can buy it direct from test out, since you've asked it. But you have to email me and ask for the price code to use.
So it's simpler to just go to the bookstore.
Simpler, but more expensive. About 20% more expensive. But it is, you can just go to the bookstore and they'll take care of it. If you're on a financial aid situation, which some of you might be, it's almost impossible to do it unless you don't go to the bookstore. So that's where they kind of go. And, you know, bookstores got to make money. Right? They're reselling it. You can buy it direct from test out. And I can't post it that way because it's against the college policy. But if you ask, as you did, just send me an email and I'll send you the price code. Right? All right, you guys are looking at me like, what's next? All right, who's nervous about, who wants to admit that they're nervous about introducing themselves? All right, that's okay. I am too. I am an introvert. You guys know what that is? Being in front of people and talking drains me. And I do it for a living, right? But, and I say this is an old joke. Some of you have heard it. Dylan's hiding back there. After I do a class like this, I have to go to my office and curl up in the fetal position for about 30 minutes on the floor. I'm kidding, but metaphorically, that's kind of how I feel, right? That's okay, though. I put everything I got into this. Can you feel it? Can you feel everything coming at you, right? All right, so we're going to do introductions. Let me turn this projector off, and I'm going to write some things on the board as we're doing this. And once we get done with this, we're going to be done. If we don't finish, you're not off the hook. We will do it next time, right? But I think we will finish. Let me stop the recording here because these people don't need to hear all this.